It's a familiar sight and sound in the skies above Lincolnshire. But what does it take to keep the Typhoon, this multi-million pound piece of technology, flying?
There are five squadrons based here at RAF Coningsby, and each one of these aircrafts needs thousands of hours of maintenance every year. And there's a real drive on to do that work more quickly and more efficiently.
On show here today, some of the latest innovations to help make that happen. Robots that can inspect aircraft in a fraction of the time it would take a human. Exoskeletons to take the strain for technicians like Alicia.
How does it feel to wear? What's it like?
So if I was to lift my arms up, it kind of holds them in place for me. So I don't have to put in any effort at all. I won't have to take as many breaks if I'm working, say, underneath the aircraft with my arms lifted up for long periods of time.
And virtual reality headsets that will help engineers to work faster.
It's currently manipulating a model of a cockpit of an F-35 aircraft. The benefits and the uses of this headset are massive, really. We're talking about reducing the maintenance time for a maintainer to complete a task on an aircraft, or, as Rob may use this cockpit in a later date, to instruct students.
But perhaps the biggest challenge for the RAF is its target to reach net zero greenhouse emissions by 2040. So how does a gas guzzler like this go green?
It does burn a lot of fuel, but yeah, we are doing some initiatives in the Air Force looking at synthetic fuels, and there's some very early trials on that. Again, you know, there's some huge leaps to make, and we're not alone. The civilian industry is also attempting to move that way.
The Typhoon fleet is now beginning to use these electric units to power aircraft on the ground instead of older diesel generators. And there are plans to do 80% of training in simulators by 2040. Jake Zuckerman, BBC Look North, at RAF Coningsby.